Hi, I'm Chris Roe, and welcome back to Understanding Cow Elk Vocalizations and Communication. In this video, we'll cover the lost mew, or as some of you may know it, is the lost cow call or lost calf call. In the previous videos, we talked about vocalizations that allowed elk to stay in general contact with one another while they were within their group, and what the structure of those vocalizations looked like. But what if an elk wants to engage another animal outside the group? What if an elk isn't in a group at all and it's off on its own somewhere? Well, if we want to change the meaning of a vocalization, then we're going to need to change the structure of that vocalization, and in my opinion, the lost mew is where all that begins. Like the mew, many of you probably heard of the lost mew, or at least have heard of the lost cow call or lost calf call. They're all the same. While it's probably used almost as much as a basic contact mew, the lost mew has a very similar misunderstanding surrounding it. Most hunters get that it's supposed to simulate a cow or a calf that's separated from the group, and it does. But what many hunters don't realize is what the lost mew actually means and how that meaning should affect their calling strategy when they're using it. In this video, we'll not only cover what the lost mew means and how to properly reproduce it, but we'll go over some of the ways that you as a hunter can get more consistent, predictable success out of using it as well.